Imagination is a strong thing. Everyone has some thoughts or hidden desires or plans for the future that they like to think about. Everyone gets lost in their own thoughts from time to time. Let's take a moment, lean back, and listen to the dreams and thoughts of the people around us. Some of their thoughts might go deeper than what you would expect. Enjoy. I wish I was a Viking. Vikings are strong. They are fearless. They overcome any obstacle, no matter how difficult. And they go wherever their boat will take them. They are kings of the sea, and strike fear into the hearts of their enemies. Wherever they go, people respect them. People acknowledge their skills, their power, and their determination. And no one would dare make fun of them. I mean, would you make fun of someone who had just slain the Almighty Kraken as it was nothing? Of course not. You would be like all the others, overwhelmed by their presence. Maybe even a little scared. Maybe you would hide, and build a high wall around your small village. But that's nothing that could stop a true Viking. Vikings never give up. They fight until they reach their goal. They take whatever they need, and they never give back. And after a difficult fight was won, they sit together and celebrate their victory. Just like a bunch of slightly confused superheroes, fighting for their own cause, just for themselves and no one else. Constantly searching for new challenges. Like if they actually needed to do something to make their ancestors proud of them. A Viking would literally defeat the strongest monster, or climb the highest mountain just to prove to himself that he was capable of doing so. No matter how high, and even if they couldn't see the peak, heck, even if there was a snowstorm halfway to the top, a true Viking would never give up. I think that is actually quite a beautiful thought. Doing things for yourself. Showing yourself that you are worthy to call yourself a fearless Viking. Someone who could conquer any distant land, or maybe even the whole world. In the end, it is you who is laughing at the world. You shout your name over the valleys and up to the highest mountain. And you turn around. Back to your friends and family who are already waiting for you at home. In the very end, you are still a humble guy deep down in your heart, and you know what is the Can you imagine how it would be like to be a dwarf? You would live far beneath the surface, maybe inside of a mountain. You would spend your days searching for diamonds and other crystals. Day in and day out, just searching for crystals. And of course, there would be magma everywhere. I mean, you are deep beneath the surface after all. It would be hot, and maybe probably even dark, but nothing could stop you from searching for gems and metals. After all, it's your job, your passion. I mean, of course it's not your only passion. Your true love would of course be the art of forging. Everyone knows that. Dwarves love forging things. Armor, weapons, jewelry, anything really, as long as it's sparkling or somewhat useful. Since you basically spend most of your day forging things, you would probably be a master of your subject. No need to go to school or anything. You would just learn it while you do it. And you would become better every single day. Until one day you would be the best smith who ever lived in the small village far beneath the surface. You know, there is actually one more thing that dwarves love even more than forging. Come on, you know what I'm talking about. It's gold. Dwarves love gold so much they could basically just lie on a heap of gold, stare at the ceiling, and be perfectly happy. Huh. But obviously they are not alone. Most creatures seem to like gold one way or the other, but there is only one creature that loves gold as much as dwarves do. I am, of course, talking about dragons. They adore gold. I think you maybe would have to fight for gold. Probably a giant dragon or something similar. But it would be okay. You have your forged weapons. It would be no problem to stay even against the mightiest of all dragons. In the end, I believe you and the dragon would sit down and rest for a while. Imagination is a strong thing. Everyone has some thoughts or hidden desires or plans for the future that they like to think about. Everyone gets lost in their own thoughts from time to time. Let's take a moment, lean back, and listen to the dreams and thoughts of the people around us. Some of their thoughts might go deeper than what you would expect. Enjoy. Do you know who the coolest guys ever are? Cowboys! They are strong, they are wild, they are crazy! They don't care what other people think. They just do their own thing. They are just happy the way they are, and they need barely anything or anyone to have a good life. Just give a cowboy a revolver and a horse, and you will see how he will leave the town on his horse, riding towards the sunset. I wish I could be a cowboy. I wish I could be this crazy, independent guy who doesn't care about the opinion of others. Who doesn't need others to be happy. Who doesn't need anyone and can do anything by himself. I would leave my village on the back of my horse, and I wouldn't stop riding until I was far, far away. Far enough to start a new life. far enough to have a chance of a new beginning, to be a new person. One who is cool and brave. One who people will like. One who finally doesn't need to be lonely anymore. Maybe I could find a tribe of Indians who could accept and adopt me. They could show me their way of living. Their way to do things. They could teach me to be happy, to be one with nature. To be one with myself, in peace and harmony. And all that it needs is this one moment of bravery and craziness. That one moment where I need to be a cowboy in order to leave and find happiness. I want to live on a Caribbean island. I mean, just imagine. The sun, the sea, awesome fruit shakes. What else could you want? And everything would be so relaxed. No school, no weird after-school activities, no homework. Just me, the beach, and the Shire Endless Ocean. How would I earn my money, you ask? Oh yeah, I have just been waiting for this question. As I present to you the one and only correct answer to that question. I will be a pirate. Just think about it. Life could be so easy. A pirate does whatever he wants to do. A pirate takes whatever he wants to have. And a pirate drinks whatever he can find. It would be an awesome life, packed with adventures and exciting sea battles. And of course, I would be victorious in every single one of them. In fact, I would be so exciting that the government would send their ships after me just to catch me. And I will be on the run. For a while at least. You know, being a pirate is fun and all, but having to run from the government your whole life sounds quite exhausting. But worry not, my friend. I already have the perfect solution. I will become a ninja. Isn't it obvious? Ninjas are the master of disguise. They are like shadows in the night, gone once you switch on the light to see them. I will be invisible to my enemies. Uncatchable to anyone who tries. I will take my gold and hide it in a small mountain village. There, I will live as a ninja and follow the path of the shadows for the rest of my life. Just me and my incredible treasure that I collected all over the seven seas. And some days I will sit there, in front of my humble ninja mansion. One day I want to be an astronaut. I mean, yeah, nothing special. Pretty much everyone wants to be an astronaut in my age. And then if you come to think about it, why wouldn't they? I get a funny feeling just thinking about it. I would be on a space station thousands, or maybe even millions of miles away from home. I would look out the window, and what do I see? Earth! So far away. So tiny. And yet, it still feels so close to me. I can just imagine how my mom would be down there searching for someone who could possibly clean my room. Well, sorry, Mom. It's not going to be me this time. After all, in space, there are more important things to do than clear your room. I have to make sure that all the spaceships are working properly, and that there is enough fuel in all of them. I have to prepare for the next big space expedition. I have to fly to different planets and explore the endless space itself. After all, I am doing it all for you, Mom. Just imagine something bad would happen to our planet. Where would we be able to go if we didn't already find another planet to live on? Where would we be able to live? As you see, being an astronaut is probably the most important task of them all. And there is nothing that could stop me from becoming one. Sometimes I imagine living in a different time. In a time where brave knights fought against evil wizards, and where we would all live in giant castles rather than small apartments. And I would be the prince of the biggest castle of them all. With rooms and rooms filled with every toy one could ask for. Oh, what am I saying? I wouldn't be the prince. Why would I be the prince? I would be the king. The one king to rule them all. The greatest, the smartest, the most fashionable. The king of all kings, a generous ruler who would bring glory and wealth to his kingdom. Everyone would love me. And everyone would praise me. And everyone would be hoping to be invited to my legendary birthday party once a year. The biggest party of them all in the biggest castle of them all, celebrating, well, the biggest king of them all. People would be looking forward to this event all year long. And once they arrive, they would be surprised with all the cool things my royal birthday party has to offer. Food and exquisite drinks everywhere? There would be soda as far as the eye could. And sweets. Just so many sweets. All of my holy knights would for one day stop slaying monsters and would gather in the Thorn Hall. They would be talking about all their great adventures and all the amazing, exciting things that happened to them. And all the other guests would stand there with hot dogs in their hands and their mouths wide open. Listening to the great adventures of my knights. And at the end of the evening, after everyone had so much to eat and so many drinks that they couldn't even count them anymore, and after everyone had so much fun and listened to so many exciting stories, I would go out on the balcony of my great castle. And I would have a look at my kingdom. the best kingdom of them all, filled with the greatest people of them all, ruled by the coolest king of them all. And I would just be happy. Nothing more and nothing less. I live in the city. It's a big city, filled with streets and cars and buildings reaching for the sky. It's never boring here. There's literally always something interesting going on. All of my friends are living here, and all of the places I know and love are here too. There is always something interesting to discover, always something new. But sometimes I feel like even this is not enough. Sometimes I feel like there should be something more exciting here. Sometimes I like to go down the streets of my district and imagine how the streets would look if a giant monster appeared out of nowhere. Maybe even a second one so that they could fight. One could be a giant evil lizard, and the other one could be an enormous brave lion trying to protect the city. There is enough place here for two monsters to fight, and maybe even for one or two superheroes to help out the giant lion. So, why have they never showed up? And more importantly, would all the busy city people even care? Or would they continue with their everyday chores, giving their best to be at work on time or getting their groceries done? Heck, would they even realize that there was a giant monster fight going on? Or would they be so busy with their own belongings that maybe they wouldn't even realize what was going on? Maybe they would just jump in their car, turn around, and complain about the traffic that would be even worse than usual. I think it's quite funny. There are so many people here, but most of them seem to not even see each other in the hassle of the crowded streets. Well, that's just the city for you. People are too busy being busy to care about anything else. in fairness, there are calm and relaxed places as well. These are the places that the lion would fight for. The places that are worth protecting. Just like the park around the corner of my building. It's right there, in the middle of the city, yet it is so quiet and peaceful. I love to go there. I love to play in that area. I love to feed the birds, and sometimes I even jump into the small pond and refresh myself. I usually stay there quite long, often until the sun starts to set. Only once the sky is already tinted in beautiful orange color, only then, it is time to go. Every one of us has a battle to fight. And while those battles can look very different, in the end, they are all the same. Well, maybe not exactly the same, but at least very similar. There are battles where you can jump up and shout your opinion to the sky. And then there are battles where you might want to be a bit more defensive. Battles where you want to hide from your opponent. Battles where you don't want to show your weak spot. Battles where you maybe have to make yourself small and wait for the right moment to strike. Strategic battles, where you have to be smart about your choices, and where you have to be sure to do the right thing at the right time. And I am not just talking about physical battles. Maybe the battle is inside of yourself, and you have to make an important decision. Or maybe you know that you are wrong, and now you are fighting with yourself as you don't want to accept it. Just prolonging the inevitable outcome, as you know you have already lost the battle. Maybe you already realize that fighting is not the right answer, but are too proud to give up. Or maybe you realize that some battles are just not worth fighting for. Maybe you are just fighting for the right thing, for the right side. Maybe you are just trying to help others. to free them from the tyranny of another person. Maybe your goal is bigger than your own safety, just something that someone needs to fight for. You see, there are many reasons to fight and many ways to fight. But in the end, the battle itself is always won the same way. All you have to do is to identify the issue and then make up your mind. Listen to what others have to say, but never lose track of your own goals. I was once the first man on the moon. Not for real, of course. Just inside my head. Anyway, it still felt epic. So I say that still counts. Well, sit down. And let me tell you about my experience. In short, it was awesome. The long version, however, has a bit more feelings to it. I was so excited I could barely look out of the window as our rocket landed on the moon. I knew that someone would have to do the first step. But since it was my fantasy, it was pretty clear who would do the honor. I put my spacesuit on and made my way to the exit. Once I arrived there, I put my hand on the door and pushed the button to open the gate. The door slowly opened and I exited our space shuttle. It was weird, I guess. I wasn't able to feel gravity for the whole flight, so I was surprised that there actually was gravity on the moon. I mean, way less gravity than back home, but still. In the end, gravity is gravity, I guess. I made a big step outside of the space shuttle and said something very epic that I once heard in a movie before. I can't really remember what it was. Something about one small for me and a couple of big shoes for the others. Oh well, something similar at least. Then I started to walk, and man, it was beautiful. I felt so light and bouncy, and the moon was so different from Earth. It was the first time that I was outside of the space shuttle for weeks, and the overall experience was just amazing. I jumped a little bit further, and then I saw it. Right in front of my eyes was my home, my planet, the only planet that I knew and loved. This sight was just breathtaking. I had seen the Earth from the space shuttle many times already, but this was something totally different. I was so free, all alone on the moon, looking back home. A single tear came out of my left eye, and up until now I can't say if it was out of happiness or sheer reverence. Even though this moment never really happened, I have never seen anything else so beautiful. Yesterday I had a dream. I was a researcher somewhere near the North Pole. I was just minding my own business when suddenly it happened. This enormous space station just appeared out of nothing right next to me. And if I say out of nothing, I mean it. It didn't make a noise. Actually, it didn't do anything out of the ordinary. It just appeared. Like it has always been there. For years, or even centuries. One second everything was normal, and the next moment, everything... was still normal, but somehow this giant structure was added to the picture. Where did it come from? How did it end up here? How can something that big just appear? Without making any noise and without harming anyone. How can an event like this, that is so strange and unexplainable, just act so casual about it? Well, at least the aftermath wasn't normal. I almost thought that I had lost it. I almost thought that I was the only one who actually realized that the giant station should not be here. But it took just a couple of minutes until nothing was normal anymore. People came out to take pictures and to ask questions. And there was this noise in the air. It didn't come from the structure, though. It came from far away, and slowly but surely got louder. One moment there was just a noise, the second moment there were helicopters everywhere. Obviously, someone tried to figure out what happened. The helicopters surrounded the structure. They basically investigated every inch of it. It seemed like the structure was a big flower, and the small helicopter bees tried to find its nectar that was hidden somewhere beneath its steely skin. The situation was weird, but strangely enough, so calm. So peaceful. Almost like time itself stood still for a moment. Then the giant structure opened its doors. In a distant land, things might be different. They might not be living the way we live here. They might not even look like us or have similar features. Heck, just think about Atlantis. Obviously, that place is underwater for a long, long time already. If anyone would want to live there, they should better be a crazy good swimmer. And if you would stay there long enough, you would clearly adapt to your surroundings. You could probably take a breath and just stay underwater for an hour or so. Maybe, and just maybe, you could even live underwater. And just surface maybe once a day, or even just once a month. And since you are already down there all the time, why not start building your house down there? The land is obviously cheap down there, and there is enough stone lying around to build a whole palace. Your own little underwater paradise, if you want to put it like that. Filled with all the treasures that you've found in the water. Water plants for a healthy living environment. Corals for the overall look and feel. And maybe even some treasures filled with gold, just to give your home a little bit of extra sparkle. It really doesn't sound bad if you put it like that, does it? I mean, it's sure different. Maybe a little bit too wet for my taste. And definitely, I would miss my TV down there. But then again, who am I to judge? If people would be happy like this, then that is something I can support. I would throw a big rock in the water from time to time. You know, just to make sure that they have enough stones to build their houses with. And I would definitely be happy to come for a visit sometimes. Well, obviously with diving equipment, as there is no way that I could hold my breath for so long. In the end, the interesting part is that even though our lives would be so different, we would still all be humans. Sure, humans with different abilities, with different hobbies and opinions on the world. Humans with lives that could not be more different from each other. But none of that really matters for me. None of that has even the slightest significance. Because I could still smile at them, and they would smile back at me. Most of my friends like to be at home. They play computer games or watch TV, or do anything similar. I'm different, though. I love to be outside. And when I say outside, I don't mean in front of my house. I mean in the forest. Some people call me old school because of that, but I couldn't care less. I simply love it outside. I love the fresh air. I love the smell of the forest. I love to see some animals playing with each other. I love all of it. Every single bit. However, the thing that I love the most about being outside is that I can just take a deep breath and let my imagination go wild. For example, just imagine there would be dinosaurs in the forest. The place would be totally different for sure. More dangerous and more exciting than ever. There wouldn't be that many trees anymore, since the big fellas need a lot of space. And for sure there would be a T-Rex around somewhere who would probably want to snack me. But just imagine how exciting it is, running through the forest knowing that there could be a dinosaur behind every single corner. Isn't that an exciting thought? Experiencing something that would otherwise not be possible at all? Basically, I am leaving home as a child who is going to play in the nearby forest. But in the forest, I am no longer a child. I am a fearless explorer who is just seeking the next amazing adventure. I am a knight, a cowboy, an astronaut, a king, you name it. I am literally everything that I want to be, and I can do whatever I want. I can experience the whole world and never even need to leave the forest. That's the power of my fantasy. My little secret that I was happy to share with you. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for listening.